Hi, today's lesson is very interesting and important to us. And in this topic we will learn about the principle of Archimedes. Archimedes of Syracuse was an outstanding ancient Greek mathematician, inventor, physicist, engineer and, also an astronomer. Although not much is known about his life, he is considered as one of the most eminent scientists and mathematicians of the classical era. Let's understand a common example of Archimedes' principle. If you drop an iron object into a pot of water, it will sink to bottom. The iron does not float because it has a greater density than the water, and yet many ships are made of iron. So, how does an iron ship float in water when an iron object sink? So, the question is that, how does an iron ship float on the water? The standard definition of floating was first recorded by Archimedes. The Archimedes principle indicates that the upward buoyant force that is exerted on a body immersed in a fluid, whether fully or partially submerged, is equal to the weight of the fluid that the body displaces. If the weight of the water displaced is less than the weight of the object will sink. Otherwise, the object will float, the weight of the water displaced equal to the weight of the object. In this principle, we learn about that when an object enters water, two forces act upon it. One is a downward or gravity force, that's determined by the object's weight. And another force is an upward or buoyancy force, that's determined by the weight of the water displaced by the object. Now let's understand the formula. The formula is F equals rho, g, v, where F equals buoyant force of a given body. Rho equals density of the fluid. V equals volume of the displaced fluid. G equals acceleration due to gravity. And also the density, rho equals rho F minus rho, g. Here rho F is the density of the fluid. Rho g is the density of the body. The formula can also be given as F equals rho F minus rho g into gv. At the end of this lesson, we learn about Archimedes' principle, and also learn how does a ship float on the water, based on Archimedes' principle.